Oh, hi. I hear you're looking for some landscape data for national planning and prioritization. Have you ever heard of LANDFIRE data? Well, you actually have probably used LANDFIRE data without even knowing it. Here, let me tell you a little bit more about what LANDFIRE is, how it was created, and how it can be used. Come on.
LANDFIRE is a program that provides over 20 national geospatial layers like vegetation, fuels, and disturbance. There are also databases and ecological models such as vegetation succession, or state in transition, vegetation time since disturbance, and fuel transition over time. It covers the whole continental United States, Alaska, and Hawaii, as well as data for the territories. Isn't that amazing? Yeah, you're right. That means you can go anywhere in the U.S. and have the same consistent product. Here's a quick overview of how this is all possible. It starts with satellite imagery from Landsat. Landsat is a satellite that's very good at seeing vegetation characteristics on the ground. It has 30 meter resolution, meaning that an area 30 meters by 30 meters is averaged into one value. Seems big, right? That does mean that it might not be the best tool for small scale management questions, but it does a fine job for larger areas. So the information that's collected by Landsat is informative, but in order to really use it, we need to understand what it's telling us about the landscape and how that matches up to what we see on the landscape and what we're trying to do. This is where the complicated part comes in. I'll sum up by saying that local and regional experts looked closely at the Landsat information and created formulas to convert that information to different vegetation, fuels, and fire regime layers and databases. Depending on where you are, there are different rule sets that determine how that conversion happens.
So now I'll tell you where you've probably seen Landfire data before and how it can be used.
Well, LANDFIRE serves as the input for many fire and fuel modeling programs. For example, WFDIS, or Wildland Fire Decision Support System, is a fundamental tool used for wildfire planning and response and relies on LANDFIRE data. Others include IFDIDIS, FLAMMAP, FOFM, etc. Here are some other ways that LANDFIRE data can be used. Comparing simulated burn probability with recent fire activity, mapping the distribution of sagebrush land cover, and mapping disturbance restoration needs.
Yeah, you're right. LANDFIRE data is pretty amazing. But this world is changing all the time, and so LANDFIRE data needs to be updated frequently as well.
Every 2 to 4 years, a new version of LANDFIRE comes out that is updated for disturbance, and where applicable, works with user feedback and suggestions. That's right, you can help make this product even better by telling the team how LANDFIRE is working for you.
Well, thanks for asking about LANDFIRE. I'm glad you're excited to use it more so that we can better manage our natural world.